everyone, Card Scout here with another unboxing video. My wife went to Target tonight and she did find some cards, and this is what intrigued me for tonight. So a box of 2021 Topps Archives Baseball. So we've got 7 packs, 8 cards per pack, total of 56 cards. Got 3 exclusive 1989 Topps big foil cards inside, and there's also some variations on those. So we could have, right here, a blue parallel of the big foil, 1 out of 70, or an autograph, 1 out of 627. So, let's see what we can get out of here. Seems like it's been harder and harder to find product out there, so this was nice to see that they've got some stuff at Target. Kind of a boring package design. I know it's trying to be retro, but it's a little plain. Get my sleeves ready to go. We'll see what we get. Pack one. Hoping for some number, hoping for some autos. Let's see what we can get. Right off the bat, we've got a Bryce Harper. Turner, Scherzer, Mike Schmidt, very off-center, Jeff Bagwell, there's this here, Francisco Lindor, Josh Donaldson, and this is a Hyungjin Ryu. But Josh Donaldson, gotta give it up for the Twins. A Minnesota boy, gotta love those Twinkies. Next pack, pack number 2. Not easy to open. Alright, we've got Odor. I think we got one of our first of the big card hits. Noma. Gurriel. Greg Maddux. Blake Street Bombers. Dante Bichette, Andrés Galarraga, and Larry Walker. It's a very cool card. Got a cat meowing here. Got Carlos Correa. So put that guy right back there, wondering where he'll end up after this offseason. Dalbec, Fletcher, and Contreras. Ding on the corner there. Pack 3. It's just fun to see all these old school designs coming back here. Perdomo. Mountcastle. Smoltz. Lou Gehrig. God, that centering. What is that all about? Grisham, yep, even worse centering here. It's almost off the top. Huff. Jim Palmer. And Ted Williams. Another ding corner. If we're coming in a box, these cards are not in very good shape. Pack 4. Tony Harley Quinn. It's a nice looking card. India, and yeah, that one is almost completely off the top. I don't know what they're doing here, Tops. Mackenzie. We got a Trout. Let's see what this card is back here. JT Realmuto. I'm gonna put Trout, no offense to the mixture, we'll put Trout in front of Mickey Mantle. Realmuto. Springer. Mancini. And Schwarber. So we've got two of our three box hits that we were looking for. Hopefully we can pull a blue or an auto with the last one. Alright, we finally got some good centering here on this 1991 design here, Willie Mays. Arihara, good centering again. Baez, good centering. Mercedes, oh, spoke too soon, there's our centering again. Crawford, nice centering. Kidding. Dave Winfield, every one of these has had like a damaged corner. Zach Greinke. I'll go on my PC for Zach Greinke. And Luis Robert. Another ding corner. Like, I don't know what you're doing, Tops, but hopefully Fanatics can do something with the MLB license. I just don't know what's going on. Excuse my cat in the background. Pack number 6. Kelenic, Singer, Bubik, off-center, A-Rod, Helton, got the big three, Barry Zito, Tim Hudson, Mark Mulder. See our last hit here, I don't know if this counts as a blue, it's got a border. Esteban Floreal. Is that a blue then? Let's just look at the number on the back here. 343, 343. It's the same, so I don't know if it is considered a blue border or a blue parallel. Could be, though. These other two are yellow. Arenado and Gallen. Got one more pack here. So we got our three box hits here. Let's see if we can get any numbered cards out of this. Some parallels, some autos, something. Let's see. Horner. Acuña Jr. Tim Salmon. Fergie Jenkins. I thought there was a second card behind it. That's how bad the centering is. Well, we got a shining star here. Pache. Dinged corner. Colton Wong. Kyle Hendricks. And Hoskins. So not a bad box. And it wasn't the best. A lot of off-center cards. A lot of dinged corners on the cards. Couple cool ones here though. So we got our three 1989 hits here. We've got Acuña Jr. And we got a Mike Trout. I don't know if that was supposed to be a sticker design. Looks like it's supposed to be a sticker. But that's what we got. If you've had any luck with the 2021 Topps Archives, let me know in the comments down below. If you are excited for Fanatics to come and see if they improve quality control over Topps and Panini. I think that would be awesome. So let's hear it if you want to hear that as well. And yeah, make sure to like, share, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you guys later.